And it is the skipper who will step forward. Milligan scores. His third penalty for his nation.
So that's it. That's the part that a lot of Cameroonians will want to see again. And we're hoping to win that one against Australia, but it didn't happen. Then it 1-1. If I still get with us, if I, a lot of Nigerians are worried. One, because they're going to play Cameroon soon, and then two, because they are AFCON champions. But what you've seen of Cameroon and this Confederations Cup, any need to be worried?
Well, before the South Africa game, everybody was relaxed. Nobody was worried. This Cameroon side, I've seen them. They're a good side.
That's right.
They're a good side. I just feel we should prepare. We should be ready for the Cameroonian side, not to sit back and just say we will defeat them, we will beat them, because I hear people coming out say Cameroon is no threat to Nigeria, no threat to Nigeria. But then, you've seen them. They're very strong, they're fast, and we know we have a problem when it comes to our defense, especially the back line, and not the wing back, the backs, because our three changing it, and we don't have a standby two. So,
rifle back.
So, if they're going to play, if Cameroonians will use the wings, it's going to be a very tough one, because we really need to, we don't have a right fullback that we can just rely on and say this one, yeah, fine.
And the Cameroonians, their left fullback, good box to box. Right now, and of course they are a compact side and they can bully any team on a good day. So the Super Eagles really love physicality for that
90
one.
Minutes. They're just like before when they won the AFCON, in what game against Egypt. Egypt had a good game, but when the Cameroonians took over the game, the Egyptians they just loved that, because the Cameroonians, they showed their strength that they can go down the way. So I just feel we should prepare for the Cameroonians, not to sit back and say, we are coming to our home, we'll defeat them. No, we should prepare.
So that's it, the indomitable Lions of Cameroon. They couldn't bite today against Australia at the Confederations Cup. But then Bruce and his team, good experience for them. And they're playing good football at the moment in terms of exposure and experience as they look forward to that crucial 2018 World Cup qualifying game against the Super Eagles of Nigeria. Sports Tonight on Channels Television, there's still so much to talk about. We are looking forward to the 2017 NBA draft. There is also on the lineup Canelo and Golovkin. What are you talking about as regards that one? And then came Mayweather and of course McGregor. So much talk about. Some of you are standing by to break this down for us. We're going to quick little combat. We're going to Washington DC. Don't go anywhere. Stay.
A CAF Champions League Group B clash between the sides that make up the bottom half of the table, but still stand a good chance of making it through to the knockout stages. In third place, Al Ahly Tripoli of Libya up against fourth place, CAF United of Zim. And this must have been balling and good numbers advancing in towards that part. So that's what we've seen from Al Ahly so far in the early stages of this clash. Back into the danger area. Here is the disappointing, and they'll be right in the last somewhat here. Very much representing a boxer who is back against the ropes here. It's attack after attack here, wave after wave, falling. Right up on the far side, over the other side of the bar, and then over the line to Zermico. The same pressure that just kept increasing and increasing until Castro is and my oh my, talk about the cherry at the top of phases in attack. It was one phase after another, too much for Cap.
This is another corner, we need to turn on this first half. They all come with
far side, and it's got straight from the corner into the back of the net. The immediate response from the Cap side that had the back against the rope. And it's a bit of a miracle, something special, a kind of magic in a magical opening 20.
My good decision. We never expected that this corner actually, you know, could just go in there on that left hand side.
Yes, oh, what a save from Zelanda. His best moment of this match, by a stretch of the imagination. In fact, the best goalkeeping moment of this match, he had to get down quickly protecting the near post. It was a thorough test from a man who's been the most outstanding in this match so far. And with that move. 2 minutes.
Welcome back. We're talking sports right here at Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. And it's been so much fun because there's so much going on in our action-packed world of sports. We've talked about taekwondo. We've taken a look at the Nigeria Professional Football League and games that have been rearranged. And, of course, we talked about the Confederations Cup. And we're still talking about it because you guys are giving your opinions, your comments. I want you to keep them coming on Twitter, Channels _ Sports, Facebook, Channels _ Sports. Fasten your seatbelts. We're going to Washington, D.C. Sonny Young is standing by. He's got so much to talk about. If Sonny is ready for us, we're so fired up to have him. Sonny, good to have you on Sports Tonight.
It's great to be on Sports Tonight again, Austin. I'd be remiss if I didn't say happy birthday to an illustrious, and I do mean illustrious, channel sportscaster there in Lagos.
Thank you
happy
so much.
Happy birthday, Austin.
Thank you so much, Sonny. We've missed you. We actually wanted to have you last week, but that didn't happen. I wanted to see your face on TV because you were so certain the Super Eagles of Nigeria we're going to be the Bafana of South Africa. And that didn't happen.
Yeah, I had to eat some crow in my prediction. I had the Super Eagles beating Bafana 3-1. Now I have to wonder, I enjoyed your conversation about Cameroon at the Confederations Cup, Austin. I think Nigeria cannot overlook Cameroon as they get ready for that 2018 World Cup qualifier. I think they really have to be prepared when they host Cameroon at the end of August.
I totally agree with you, Sonny. We can't overlook Cameroon. But let's talk about some of those guys that cannot be overlooked for the 2017 NBA Draft.
That's right, Austin. Later Thursday night in New York City, early Friday morning in Lagos, the National Basketball Association will hold its annual draft of college and international players. The Philadelphia 76ers have the number one pick. They made a trade earlier this week with the Boston Celtics to get that number one pick. They're expected to take Markelle Fultz, a 19-year-old point guard who played one season of college basketball for the University of Washington in the Northwestern United States. Two players with ties to Africa could be among the 60 players selected in the NBA draft. Let me give shout-outs for Peter Jock. He was born in Sudan, played at the University of Iowa. And another player with African ties, Frank Ntilikina. He was born in Belgium, represents France on the international stage. His parents are both Rwandan. So we'll see where they go in the draft. But it's going to be tough no matter how these selections go, Austin, for any team to dethrone the Golden State Warriors. They were truly golden this past NBA season.
I totally agree with you. I'm for the guys, the hopefuls for the NBA draft. I listened to, Isaiah Isaac, and he says, look, anywhere it goes. So they have the fingers crossed. Sonny will continue to monitor it. Let's talk about the big guys who get ready for the 2017 NBA Awards. That one, of course, should have James Harden in there. And, of course, the one that I keep saying we should test for the alien DNA.
That guy with the alien DNA, Austin, our friend Russell Westbrook of the Oklahoma City Thunder, I think he's the favorite to win the big award on Monday night, also in New York, the annual NBA award ceremony. League Most Valuable Player, I think Westbrook will win that award after having a truly historic season, averaging a triple-double. James Harden and Kawhi Leonard are the two other candidates for that award, but I think it's going to go to Russell Westbrook on Monday night.
No doubt, but you will agree with me that Kawhi Leonard actually had a good season, but unfortunately, playing at the same time that Westbrook and Harden are on fire. So
yeah, no question. I think Kawhi Leonard definitely one of the young emerging stars in the NBA. Austin, he got hurt in the playoffs against the Golden State Warriors. The Spurs were very competitive up until Kawhi got hurt. So, yeah, I think he's a player to watch, definitely, in the NBA.
Sonny, let's talk boxing on September 16th. Ooh, I cannot wait for that. When Canelo and Triple G will get into that ring for the world middleweight title fight in Las Vegas. Any fight you take to Las Vegas, you know it's serious business. Those guys are promoting the fights.
Promoting it all over the place, Austin. They made two stops this week. First one was in London, and then the very next day they were in New York City to promote the fight. I think it's going to be an action-packed fight, Austin. These are two guys who come forward. Hmm. They don't dance around the ring too much. They like to come forward, and I think we're going to see – I wouldn't be surprised if we see a knockout. I think it's very possible. At this point, I think I'm going to go with Canelo. I mean, I know it's a little early – but I think Canelo might be he's going to be a handful for Triple G, but I think it'll be a great fight.
Wow, Sonny. Triple G, you going for Canelo? Oh, okay. No, it's okay. That's your pick. Well, I love the fact that we'll see boxers actually come forward. Let's talk about this guy. He doesn't really like coming forward. He loves the defense, like Mayweather Jr. I don't know, Sonny.
I've been walking. You're right about the defense. He does that kind of shoulder roll thing.
But I'm undefeated.
You know, how can you not pick Floyd Mayweather on August 26th when he fights Conor McGregor? McGregor has never once fought a boxing match.
Wow.
And I just, you know, no matter how much power Conor McGregor has, Floyd Mayweather Jr. is a craftsman, a ring general, and I certainly don't see him losing to Conor McGregor.
I know, because we hear that it's going to be boxing rules. And I mean, McGregor can't kick. So I'm going to be Floyd.
No kicking allowed, and no elbowing either, as far as I know. So I think McGregor is in over his head. It's going to be more of a spectacle than anything else, but I don't think it's going to be much of a competition in terms of a great boxing match.
But no, come on. Sonny, explain to me, is this for sure? Because I don't know what sort of boxing fights we're going to have on August the 26th.
Well, the first thing, one of the things to keep in mind, Austin, is Floyd Mayweather Jr., bottom line, is a businessman. And Conor McGregor, he knew that McGregor would bring that MMA audience to the fight. You know, he's very popular, might be if not the most popular MMA fighter out there. So I think a lot of people, it'll be that curiosity factor to see what McGregor can do, and they're going to tune in to watch the fight. I think that's what's going to bring the fans.
Sonny, you know, I don't know overall sort of figures, but just this morning was confirmed again that Floyd Mayweather Jr. can make close to $180 million. Sonny, is it too late for both of us to get into boxing?
Well, you're only 25, Austin. It's a little too late for me, I think, at this stage to get into boxing. But, yeah, the money is just incredible that they're talking about for this fight. And, you know, they're saying McGregor could easily make over $100 million, which is by far his biggest payday.
Oh, wow. Sonny, I must say thank you so much. You know what you did? You did it like Canelo and Triple G. You came forward tonight. Thank you so much, Sonny. I know. Thank you so much, Sonny.
Thank you, Austin.
So that's it. Our Voice of America correspondent, Sonny, I'm talking to us about.